A recent study of bottlenose dolphins in the Halifax River and northern Indian River Lagoon shows that if one of the animals is in trouble, many others may be too. West News Claire Metz reports the study shows much more than first thought. Dolphins are family-oriented, forming lasting relationships even into adulthood.
Hub SeaWorld Research Institute partnered with Cornell University's College of Veterinary Medicine following several dozen bottlenose dolphins in this area for a decade. Turns out dolphins are homebodies.
Many of them maintained associations with their mother and had preferential associations with their siblings.
Hub SeaWorld research scientist Wendy Noak-Durden says it was quite a surprise to see dolphin calves, previously thought to leave their mothers after they've weaned, stay close to her and to siblings well into adulthood. That's particularly important when it comes to conservation. The calves learn how to survive from mom, so if she becomes entangled in fishing gear, let's say, the calves are likely to do the same. Demonstrates just how critical public awareness is.
You see a dolphin nearby reeling in your gear or recycling your fishing gear so that it doesn't end up in the water where it puts wildlife at risk.
The study provides scientists with insights into population health, foraging, and reproductive success. Included in it, the area around Ponce Inlet, a preferred hangout for sharks hunting bait fish who occasionally bite a swimmer instead. The study shows dolphins have those nasty interactions with sharks as well. A third of the local bottlenose dolphin population have shark bite marks on them. And scientists surmise that may be another reason mom keeps her calves with her for years.
That might lead the animals, the mothers, to stay with their calves a little bit longer and to stay in tight groups with each other, since perhaps it's a riskier situation.
While bottlenose dolphins are thankfully not endangered, there are threats to this playful population. Scientists say this family ties study gives new guidance to ongoing protection measures. In Volusia County, Claire Metz, West 2 News.